Okay, what's the alphabet here?
A.
Just A.
A. What's the language? What's the language here?
It can't have only three A's.
It can or cannot have?
It can't. Cannot.
Yeah. Can't have three A's? But yeah. Well, the alphabet has only A in it, so any string will have only A's. So the only thing that does not belong to the language is three A's. Anything else belongs to the language. Okay, so it's not a very interesting language, but it's a very interesting example for studying equivalence or studying DFA minimization. So the language is A-N, where N is greater than or equal to zero, in fact, but N is not equal to three. This is the language. We don't care much about the language. We care about studying equivalence or studying minimization. So our objective is to try to minimize this DFA. Okay, now let's try to do it by inspection first. Do you think that this is minimizable? Can you find two states that are equivalent? Can you find two equivalent states that we can merge? Okay, in fact, you will not find any. This is minimal, but we'll see how the algorithm will prove that it's minimal. Okay, so this is a minimal DFA. We'll see how the algorithm, the systematic procedure, proves that this is minimal. So what would be the first step in the algorithm?
To divide the states.
Yeah, divide it into?
Two equivalence classes.
Yeah, two equivalence classes. The first equivalence class has?
Substates.
Yeah, the F1, the accept states, has Q0, Q1, Q2, and Q4. Q0, 1, 2, 4. And the other equivalence class has
Q3.
So there is nothing to study in this equivalence class. We know that it has only one state, and there are no other states that we can compare it with. So this is just distinguishable from all other states. But now it remains to see which states here are distinguishable and which are indistinguishable. So we have to study all pairs. We have to study them two states at a time to compare two pairs. How many pairs do we have here? How many pairs of states should we study? So we should compare Q0 with Q1, Q0 with Q2, Q0 with Q4, no, not 3. And what else? So we should compare every two states, each pair of states. So we should compare Q1 with?
Q2.
Q1 with?
Q2.
With Q2. And Q1 with?
Q4.
Q4. And Q2.
2
with Q4. Are there any other pairs that we need to compare? So these are the pairs. Okay, so when you have n states here, n states in an equivalence class, how many pairs will you have? What's the number of pairs when you have n to n states? What's the general rule?
Two.
2 power n?
No.
But this is clearly wrong, because this is not 2 power 4. This is what?
6.
This is 6. What's the formula that will give us 6 in this case? Yes?
N choose 2, or you can n times n minus 1 over 2.
Yeah, exactly. So it's n, you need a combination of 2 out of n. And this is the same as n minus 1 divided by 2. This is an intuitive formula. It's just like a tournament. You know, you have four teams. How many games do you need in order for these four teams to play each other? Every team needs to play with all other teams. How many games do you need? The number of games is n multiplied by n minus 1, because each team is going to play n minus 1 teams, but then we divide by 2. Why? Because we are counting each game twice. If we count team X playing with team Y and team Y playing with team X, we count it as 2 games, but in fact it's 1 game, so we divide by 2. So this is the number of states that we need, the number of pairs. And we need to compare them. So what do we assume initially? Indistinguishable. We assume that all four are equivalent until proven distinguishable. Okay. Now, I need to compare Q0 and Q1. Do I compare the output or the input?
No.
The output. I compare where, I look at where they go. So Q0 on an A goes to Q1, right? Q1 on an A goes to Q2. Do they go to two states that belong to the same equivalence class? Or in other words, do Q1 and Q2, from the algorithm's point of view, what does the algorithm think at this point about the relation between Q1 and Q2? It thinks that it's the indistinguishable. Okay? The algorithm at this point doesn't see any difference between Q1 and Q2. It thinks that they're indistinguishable. So it's going to say Q1 and Q2 are the same state, or equivalent states. So it's going to say, okay, therefore, Q0 and Q1 are indistinguishable, and in iteration 2, they will continue to be indistinguishable. Now, what about Q0 and Q2? Q0 on an A goes to Q1, Q2 on an A goes to Q3. Now, what does the algorithm think about the relation between Q1 and Q3? Does the algorithm see them as two different? Yeah, it sees them as distinguishable. Why? Because they belong to two different equivalence classes. Q1 belongs to the accept equivalence class, and Q3 belongs to the non-accept equivalence class. So at this point, the algorithm sees Q1 and Q3 as distinguishable. So it's going to say, since Q0 and Q2 on an A go to two different states, then now I detect a distinction between Q0 and Q2. Now the algorithm has just detected a distinction between Q0 and Q2. So there is a D. Okay. Now what about the relation between Q0 and Q4? Where does Q4 go on an A? It goes to Q4. Now, what does the algorithm think about the relation between Q1 and Q4? Here. What does the algorithm think? It thinks that they're the same at this point. So it's going to say, I cannot distinguish between Q0 and Q4. So it's going to keep this as an I. Okay. Now, we will look at the relation between Q1 and Q2. So we'll see where they go. Q1 on an A goes to Q2. Okay. Q1 on an A goes to Q2. Q2 on an A goes to Q3. What does the algorithm think about the relation between Q2 and Q3? It thinks that they are different. So Q1 and Q2, here I have a D. Now, what about Q1 and Q4? Q4 on an A goes to Q4. What does the algorithm think at this point about the relation between 2 and 4? It thinks that they are indistinguishable. So it will say that 1 and 4 are also indistinguishable. What about 2 and 4? So 2 on an A goes to 3. What does the algorithm think about the relation between 3 and 4? It thinks they are distinguishable. One is accept, one is non-accept. So it's going to say 2 and 4 are also distinguishable. Because they go to two different states on an A. Okay? Clear? So the concept is to determine if two states are distinguishable or indistinguishable. You look at all of their transitions on all the symbols in the alphabet. In this case, we only have one symbol. And see if they ever go to two distinguishable states. If they go to two states that are either the same or equivalent, then that counts as indistinguishable. All right, so two iterations are not enough here. We need another iteration. So we will need now to examine, why do we need another iteration, by the way? Why does it make sense to consider another iteration? Yes?
We need to check to make sure if the changes we made during the last iteration will then affect it.
Exactly. Again. Yeah, exactly. That's the right answer. We have made changes. During this iteration, we detected three distinctions, or we distinguished between three pairs of states. And these changes here may in turn affect the relations between other states. So now we will go, of course, in the next iteration, do you need to examine the D's? The D's are already D's. We have already distinguished them. And they will continue to be distinguished forever. So you cannot go from a D to an I. You can go from an I to a D, but you cannot go from a D to an I. All right, so let's look at this I, see if we can change it to a D. Zero on an A, zero goes to Q1. And Q1 on an A goes to Q2. So this goes to Q1, and this goes to Q2. Now, has the algorithm changed? Has the algorithm changed its mind about the relation between Q1 and Q2?
Yes.
What's the current relation between Q1 and Q2? Now it's D. Now the algorithm has detected that Q1 and Q2 are distinguishable. Therefore, Q0 and Q1 are also distinguishable. Because Q0 on an A goes to Q1, Q1 on an A goes to Q2, and in the previous iteration, the algorithm has detected a difference between Q1 and Q2. So now this difference will cause Q0 and Q1 to be distinguishable. And we just don't touch the D. Now Q0 and Q4, okay, Q0 on an A goes to Q1, Q4 on an A goes to Q4. What does the algorithm think at this point about the relation between Q1 and Q4? It still thinks that they are indistinguishable. But we're not done yet. It may change its mind later. But at this point, it still thinks they are indistinguishable. Therefore, the relation between Q0 and Q4 remains indistinguishable. The D remains a D. Now, what does the algorithm think about the relation between Q1 and Q4? Q1 on an A goes to Q2. So Q1 on an A goes to Q2, and Q4 on an A goes to Q4. What does the algorithm think about? Sorry, we are examining the relation between Q2 and Q4. We're still looking at Q1 and Q4. So the relation between Q1 and Q4, Q1 on an A goes to Q2, Q4 on an A goes to Q4, and Q2 and Q4, in fact, are distinguishable now. The algorithm sees them as distinguishable. So, looking at the relation between Q1 and Q4, Q1 on an A goes to Q2, and Q4 on an A goes to Q4, what does The algorithm thinks at this point about the relation between Q2 and Q4. It thinks that it's a D. So therefore, now Q1 and Q4 are distinguishable. And of course, the D remains a D. Now we have one I remaining. So we need one more iteration to see if the changes that we made in iteration, this is iteration 1, iteration 2, iteration 3, the changes that we made in iteration 3 caused this to become a D. And we look at 0 and 4. 0 on an A goes to Q1. 4 on an A goes to Q4. Now, what does the algorithm think about the relation between Q1 and Q4? It thinks that they're distinguishable. So this means that this I will become a D. So what did the algorithm do here? It iteratively detected or determined that all pairs of states are distinguishable. We looked at all different pairs, and it detected that all pairs are distinguishable. Even though it initially assumed that they're all equivalent, it iteratively detected the distinction, and it distinguished. And what does this mean from DFA minimization point of view?
You can't minimize.
You can't. There are no equivalents. The algorithm told us that there are no equivalent pairs of states, and all states are distinguishable, and this is a minimal DFA. Okay, any questions?